welcome to an introduction to what's going to follow for the rest of this afternoon. We are going to talk about how to assess the quality of your data. I know it's something that's on a lot of your minds. You've got your existing data set with you, and how do you actually tell whether or not it's clean data or dirty data? So, series of different presentations, and this is how they're going to go. First, Javier is going to get up, and he's going to talk about completeness of data and how to determine fitness for use. Then, I'm going to stand up and I'm going to give you an overview of all the different tools that are available to help you make assessments. These tools are all free and open access, and most of them are possible and included on your flash drive. Then, John stands up and focuses on geospatial data. He'll give you a few techniques on how to make assessments of geospatial data. And then Javier is up again. And this time it's a particularly focused presentation on taxonomic assessments. And I know a lot of you are interested in that. You've got your scientific names, other taxonomic information. How do you tell whether or not it's a good name? Good classification. And last but not least, I still think we're going to go with this presentation. There's some future data considerations. But I might get bumped. So, first, a little background. How widespread exactly is taxonomic data? Well, in this recent study that was conducted, out of 308,000 georeference plant observations from 51,000 different sources of herbarium specimens across the Himalayas, there were 22,100 unique species names. Okay? Now, after correcting the spellings and updating synonymous names, that total was reduced down to 12,980. So that's a lot of dirty data in there. Okay? So about 42% of the names in the original data were erroneous, obsolete, and something wrong. So when we're talking about assessing data quality, it's these kind of things. It's assessing whether or not, you know, for example, your scientific names contain spelling mistakes, match an existing checklist. And so these are some of the reasons that we're doing this. If we don't clean our data, if we're not able to make successful assessments, there could be consequences. And ultimately, the result of specifically bad taxonomy would be erroneous scientific conclusions and faulty policies. So really this is fundamental to get right if we're going to base anything off of our biodiversity data. Now an interesting example that I was going to talk to you about is an assessment that was made on Duke of Spain's data. And it's particularly based on a paper that was written by Javier, who's in our presence today. And the article is, you can link to it from that. So, a brief introduction to GBIF Spain's data. Well, there's over 5 million records hosted by GBIF Spain alone, and there's over 152 different resources that make up that 5.2 million records, plus an additional 16 resources with another 700,000 records from other publishers, and the largest data set of which is about 1 million records. Now, in this assessment that was made by Javier and his team, they ran a bunch of different assessments. So I hinted at taxonomic assessments. Well, Javier also ran geographic assessments and some temporal assessments. Now, just again, because this is an introduction and Well, correct some spelling errors in names. Standardize alternate spellings to a standard list of names. Match unmatched names. Names that don't match against a catalog of life or well-established checkers. And try and convert out-of-date names to the current accepted name. So the methodology is explained in this article that you can all read in your own spare time, but I thought I would just give you an idea of the work that went into it, okay? First, they constructed a taxonomic tree, given all the different taxonomic concepts in these almost 6 million records. They identified which ones were null or didn't match against any kind of available checklist, such as the catalog of life. And where they weren't able to match, they tried to search in other checklists. There was actually a manual review that was done. So where they weren't able to make a match yet, they tried to locate misspellings or taxon level displacements. So things are done automatically sometimes, and sometimes they're done manually as well. Then the remaining taxon strings that again didn't match. They were searched for in specialized literature. So, probably a manual step, again, taken here. And when the available taxonomy in the literature wasn't able to match up against the catalog of life, then an attempt was made to reasonably assess the taxonomic placement of the taxonomic concept. And if all that failed, and the corresponding taxon levels were just like, what? That's it. So what was the outcome of Javier's taxonomic assessment? Well, approximately 287,000 distinct taxon strings existed in the dataset to begin with, okay? And after all those different steps, all those assessments that were made, that was reduced down to 182,000 strings belonging to 3,000 So pretty successful. And hopefully all of you can pick up the skills this afternoon to be able to make the same assessments and hopefully clean your data in a similar way. So that's the introduction. I hope it leads in well in this presentation and you all get what it is that we're trying to present you this afternoon. Is my data dirty? Or is it clean? And if it's dirty, how do I visualize the data, assess its quality, and hopefully clean it up?